And one of the problems of laptops is that they heat up really, really fast. And it's really hard to keep them cool down compared to PCs. So in this video, I'm going to go over some things you can do to speed up your computer by cooling it down. The first step is actually the most expensive, or not that expensive, however you want to look at it. But you might want to consider cleaning your laptop, especially of dust. You can actually buy the little air canisters and just like blow out any dust. And that actually helps quite a bit for cooling down your laptop. And in my case, I needed something much more serious. I needed to actually replace the CPU paste, the thermal paste. It cost me about $60 to get the laptop cleaned and install some new CPU paste. If you don't know what CPU paste is, it's a little paste they put on the chip and it helps disperse the heat from your laptop. And I was having some serious issues, like I couldn't even run a Photoshop action without the computer heating up and turning off, or I couldn't even apply color correction to my YouTube videos, because if I did that, the computer would turn off. So I went to this place in Seoul, Phil's computer repository, a cool guy. If you're ever in Korea, check it out. And that took the temperature of my laptop from, I think my laptop was idling around like the 70s, which is actually pretty high. Most laptops idle from like 30 to 60 or something. But whenever I exported or worked in Photoshop, it would spike up to like 87 or even 90. Like, it was pretty high and the computer would shut down. So before you buy anything, before you buy a cooling pad, before you do all these external measures, you should replace the CPU paste on your laptop and or get it dust cleaned. That's the most important thing above everything. Best $60 of my life. My laptop runs like it was new all over again. The next few things you can do are actually pretty common things you might have already heard of. You can get a cooling pad for your laptop, but don't be fooled by these cooling pads. I'm not gonna recommend any one in particular. You can find whichever one suits your laptop best, but these things are everywhere and they actually only cost, they only reduce the temperature of your laptop by like 3 or 4 degrees, which doesn't sound like a lot, but actually, in my case, since I do a lot of video editing, every degree counts. You know, I had one video card burn up because of the temperature inside of the laptop. So if only I had done this sooner, I wouldn't have lost one video card. And so yeah, find yourself a nice cooling pad for your laptop for those extra few degrees. And might I add, you might also want to think about adding cooling paste to your video cards if you use them excessively. Perhaps I should have done that also. Next, so we talked about the thermal paste, the cooling pad. Here's one thing you probably never heard of. In fact, I just did. They are called laptop vacuums, thermal vacuums. They're actually a pretty cool concept. I have two attached to my computer, and ever since attaching these to my laptop, I think each one lowered the temperature of my computer by like 5 or 6 degrees, you know. I mean, in the boxes, they claim they do like 10 to 20 degrees of cooling down. But in my case, I only saw like maybe 6 degrees each card. So when you take into consideration the cooling paste for the CPU, then you have like a cooling pad under the laptop. And then you have, well, actually most laptops only need one laptop vacuum. Now my computer idles like around 47 degrees, which is a big difference from like 60s, 70s, you know. So my laptop is doing great. I can export no problem. But let's say you are poor and you cannot afford to do any of these things. Then you can do one of the things I used to resort to. You're actually going to open up your task manager. You're going to select the program, go to details. Then you're going to find your program under the details. You're going to right click set Affinity, and you're going to see how many cores your CPU is running on. And I used to edit my photos and videos with only one core, because if I use all of them, not even 20 seconds later, the computer will shut down. So this is going to cause your editing and video to go much, much slower. I mean, it will take an hour to render a video, but at least it's going to render the video without overheating. So consider that like a last-ditch effort. Reduce the cores by setting the Affinity in your CPU. And if you do all these things, I guarantee you your laptop's gonna run spanking brand new. You know, especially like photographers and video editors and even graphic designers, they're always chasing the latest and greatest CPU or video cards or whatever new toy is out. There's a new laptop, they need to get it, right? Especially when it comes to Macs. But sometimes all you need to do is cool down your laptop and it'll run like new, just like mine did. So I hope you found this video useful. I know I'm gonna get a ton of questions like, hey, where's the link to buy so-and-so vacuum or cooling pad? Just do the research yourself. You know, I use the cheapest ones I can find. They work just fine for me. I'm sure you can find better. So thank you for watching and good luck.